Hello, good morning one and all. In this session, we discuss about properties of asymptotic notation. In previous session, we discuss about the different types of asymptotic notation, that is O, big O, that is upper bound, omega, lower bound, and theta is an average bound. These are the three types of asymptotic notation. In today's session, we discuss about what are the properties of asymptotic notation. It is very important question for examination point of view. It will be appear for 8 to 10 marks. So before going to start in properties of asymptotic notation, let's discuss what is the meaning of that property, how it will be applied in this asymptotic notation. If an algorithm has two executable parts, the analysis of this algorithm can be obtained using the following theorem. In the examination, they will ask to write the properties of asymptotic notation. In similar way, we have to write. Prove the following theorem. In examination, they will ask, prove the following theorem. If F1 of N belonging to O big O, that is big O G1 of N, and F2 of N belonging to O G2 of N, then what is the value of F1 plus F2 if the O has maximized? They will ask like that. Now, before going to start the properties, different types of properties, one important note is that the same assertion is true. The same assertion is true. This is very important. The same assertion is true if we replace big O notation by omega or theta notation. Now, we will discuss about the properties. First property, we call it as a general property. We call it as a general properties. This is very important question for examination point of view. First general property says that if F of N is big O of G of N, then A into F of N is big O of G of N. This is the property says that. Before going to explain this general property, in this property it is true for big O, theta and omega. All the three asymptotic notations will be true for this general property. So we are using both O, omega and theta. Say, if first general property says that if F of N is big O of G of N, then A into F of N is big O of G of N. It means I will take one small example how it will general property works. Example, if you take F of N is equal to 2N square plus 5, what is the value of big O? The big O indicates N square. So, we have to write the degree of this one. We have to exclude this one. Right? So, big O should be N square. Similarly, then 7 into Fn, what is the value? So, 7 into, what is the F of N? That is F of N is 2N square plus 5. 2N square plus 5. 2N square plus 5. Finally, what is the value? 7 into 2, 14 N square plus 35. So, what is the order of this also? Big O of N square only. So, this is the first general property in asymptotic notation. Similarly, we can write it as a big O. Instead of writing O here, we have to write big omega or big theta. We can write anything because this property is true for all the three conditions. It is true for all the three conditions, that is big O, theta and omega. Second property says that, now I will explain about second property. Second property says that reflexive. Second property indicates reflexive. What is the meaning of reflexive? I will explain. If F of N is given, if F of N is given,
then f of n is big O of f of n. Big O of f of n. This is the property says that big O of f of n. Now, I will explain one example for reflexive, how it will be works. If f of n indicates n square, so order should be always n square only. One thing, in this reflexive property, only a big O condition is true for reflexive, because it will be reflect the value and it will be appear on the condition, only upper one. So big O indicates that what is the value? N square, big O of n square. Big O means only big O is true. So big O is an upper bound. It is only true for upper bound values. Clear? So this is the reflexive property. Already I explained about two properties. One is general property and second is reflexive property. Now I will explain third property, that is transitive property. Third property is transitive property. What is the meaning of transitive property? If f of n is big O of g of n and g of n is big O of h of n. Now, then f of n is equal to O of h of n. So it means there are three conditions. If f of n is big O of g of n and g of n is big O of h of n and f of n is big O of h of n. This condition also a upper bound only. Only it will be true for big O condition. So big O asymptotic notation, it is only true for big O. Say reflexive and transitive only for asymptotic notation for big O. For general property O, for it will be true for all the three conditions, that is big O, omega and theta. Now I will show the one example for transitive. Clear? Now what is the example? This is first example. If f of n is equal to n, if f of n is equal to n comma g of n, I will write as n square. Assume this all the example should be, I am assuming g of n is equal to n square and h of n is equal to n cube. So these are the assumption of example. Now n is, what is the value for transitive property? So n indicates n is big O of n square. N is big O of n square. Now similarly and n square, this is n square is big O of n cube. Clear? Then n, what is the value n? Again we have to write for n cube, right? N is big O of n cube. So this n is related to n square, n square is related to n cube, n cube is related to n. So these are all the upper bound condition only. So transitive condition, it will be n is related to n square is related to n cube and so on. N is less than n square is less than n cube is less than n4. Like that it goes on up to n term. So this is a upper bound for transitive property. That is upper bound means big O. Now I will explain fourth property that is symmetric property. Now in symmetric properties, it only applicable for theta value. It is only applicable for theta value. I will show. If f of n is theta of g of n, then G of N is theta of F of N.
If F of N is theta of G of N, then G of N is theta of F of N. Only we are using a theta condition, because the symmetric property only true for theta value. That is, theta is the average cone, it should be an average, right?
So now I will explain the example. One example I will take. F of N is equal to N square. G of N is equal to N square. What is the value? See here. F of N is equal to theta of F of N is equal to theta of N square. Similarly, G of N is also a theta of N square, because we have to write order. Clear? So this is the one of the property, that is symmetric property. There are five properties. Last property I will explain. Fifth property
is transpose symmetric.
Fifth property is transpose symmetric. Now I will explain. This transpose symmetric property is true for both big O and omega. Now I will explain. If F of N is equal to O of G of N, then G of N is omega of F of N.
This is the transpose symmetric definition. Now I will explain one example. Assume F of N is N, G of N is N square. What is the value? Then N is O of N square, and N square is omega of N. So both are upper bound and lower bound. So this is only for big O and omega, upper bound and lower bound. This is the transpose symmetric property. If F of N is O of G of N, then G of N is omega of F of N, then finally F of N is equal to N into G of N is equal to N square. Now how will we write? N is big O of N square. So we have to write cross. Next, N square is big omega of N. This is the condition for transpose symmetric matrix. Now there are five properties. First property is general property. It is true for all the three asymptotic notation. And second is reflexive property, that is true for only big O, and transitive property, that is true for big O only. And finally, symmetric properties is true for only a theta condition. And finally, the last property is transpose symmetric property, that is true for both theta and as well as omega. These are all for the today's class. If you have any doubts regarding this concept, please message me in the comment box. This is very, very important question for the examination point of view. It will be appear for 8 to 10 marks. I will repeat again, this is very important question. See here, first property is general property. Next is reflexive property. And next is transitive property. And next is symmetric property. And finally, move on to the transpose symmetric property. Similar to this properties, they will ask in the examination of different types of questions. Like I will assume some more example in the next class. I will take some more example to solve this problem. This question will appear for theory for 8 to 10 marks. If they ask for problem 4 to 5 marks, they will ask. So this is very important question. In module 1, time and space complexity is very important. And second thing is asymptotic notation and properties of asymptotic notation. And finally, we will discuss about best case, worst case and average case in the upcoming session. So thank you one and all for the listening this video. If you have any doubts, please message me in a comment box, and also please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you one and all for listening this video.